Is there a heaven for a G? I wonder if heaven got a ghetto. I know these were controversial questions from Tupac that had true servants of God in disgust and questioning his sanity. Though he may not have meant it in a literal, I have a feeling he was very much serious in some fashion. Misunderstood, maybe. Who knows his thought process in the creation of this concept, as most songs written by Tupac, you as a listener would have to understand life from a troubled individual's vision to resonate with the lyrics and get the correct connection with Tupac as he delivers his display of thoughts through music and poetry. I can tell you this, Tupac meant no harm by asking these questions. I'm going to go into depth with this subject because Tupac is very easily misunderstood because of the perception displayed of him. The thing he says on wax and on camera, his troubles with the law, his controversial confrontations with other individuals in the industry, his being robbed, shot, and later shot again to be murdered, all contribute to the focus being on his negativity and missing the point. If you know anything about a thug, you know he came into this world in an undeserved, unfortunate situation. Merely nothing was given. A lot of needed love was missing. The place to rest daily may not have been enough to call home, and a lot of what he has gained had to be taken against will or fought for. A thug spends a lifetime in harsh conditions. A thug can sometimes feel like he's being punished just for existing. He's treated like he's a nuisance to society, like he's in a way, and all that he has to offer is not good enough to anybody except other people as poor and unfortunate as him. This is the thug life Tupac was continuously mentioning. Even that was misunderstood, and I can understand why, but he had a political code for the term, and it was more for uniting and building than promoting poisonous destruction in society. A lot of the wrongdoings a thug does is because he has to, not because he wants to. Real thugs become thugs by nature. If someone became a thug by choice because he wanted to, that's a fake thug. Fake thugs are even worse of a nuisance than real thugs. They do unnecessary harm to society, and excessively. Tupac asks, is there a heaven for a G? Because on earth, a G is accepted nowhere. When he's in his neighborhood, he's stalked by police. And the neighbors who make an honest living toot their noses up at him because of how he makes his living, the things he does, and the things he doesn't do. A G is definitely damned if he does and damned if he doesn't. A G does not fit in with normal people outside of his neighborhood or with the higher ups in higher places. A G is highly likely to not be welcome to other poor neighborhoods like the one he lives in, because the other neighborhoods may have static with his neighborhood. A G may go to church and feel uncomfortable because the people there are uncomfortable with his presence, and this goes for nearly anywhere he goes. A G is not welcome on TV for various different reasons, so they just pay actors to portray G's, even in the music industry. The world is against a G, and every day is a constant battle for a G. Through all the problems a G may have to face throughout every day, he still seeks a reason to smile and feel relieved. There has to be a better life for a G, because all his life he's been living in hell. Does being born in hell mean he deserves to be there forever? Maybe something better awaits a G through death. A G is destined to die fast anyway. Tupac wondered if heaven got a ghetto. Put yourself in the shoes of those who've been dirt poor all their life. They're tired of being counted out, denied, and banned from everything they try and participate in. They can't even commune with other neighborhoods as poor as themselves because they don't want to share the little bit that they have. People tell them to get up and work, but employers don't want their services because of where they live, how they look, what they may have done in the past, and risks they're capable of taking by letting them in. A G is a cancer that nobody wants. A better life in a better place looks hopeless for a G. Sure, a G may be accepted into heaven, but the way life is treating him here on earth, he may make it to heaven and still lack embracement and comfort and feel like he'll only fit in only if there was a ghetto nearby. Tupac was not aiming to give heaven a bad look, sabotage it, or give the idea that people who live outside of law deserves to be spared and welcome to the kingdom. Just simply hypothetically thinking, there has got to be a better place, a better situation for us, because we don't deserve this situation that we were born in. All of us did not choose to live this way. If you slept with the sheep, been sheltered and cared for in a place of safety, you'll never understand the life in the mind of those who slept and ran wild with the wolves, who had to con, take, and make a tax for everything they wanted. Being a thug from the ghetto is definitely not all good, but it's not all bad either. It may be hard to agree from the outside looking in. You may have to do some corrupt things just to do some justice for yourself. When everyone is against you, even the ones who live at home and next to your home, you're short of resources, so survival is mandatory. Tupac simply was saying, we weren't all stealing and dealing and killing, but we all have to be punished for it, just for being around it and looking like it. Can't we just live a better life in a better place? It seems like everyone is out to do away with us, but no one is willing to help us, not even us. We can't have peace until the niggas get a peace too. Is there a heaven for a G? I wonder if heaven got a ghetto. And all the pain, show me some happiness again. I'm going blind, I spend my time in the cell. Ain't living well, I know my destiny is hell. But did I fail? My life is in denial. And when I die, baptized in eternal fire, shed so many tears. And one day we'll all be together. Until then I'm ready for whatever. The only way to change me is maybe put my brains out. Stuck in the middle of the game to get the pain out. Pray to my God every day, but he don't listen. The poverty bothers me. My mama's working wonders in the kitchen. Listen, I can hear her crying in the bedroom. Praying for money, we'll never get what she be dead soon. Am I wrong for wishing I was somewhere else? I'm 13, can't feed myself. Can I blame daddy cause he left me? Wish he would've hugged me too much like him. So my mama don't love me on my own at an early age. Getting paid and I'm strapped so I'd never be afraid. What did I go astray? I'm hanging in the back streets, running with G's and dope fiends. Where they jack me, can't turn back. My eyes on the prize, I got nothing to lose. Everybody gotta die, say goodbye to the bad guy. Give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, kill a nigga, he's a hero. Get it back to the kids who the hell cares. One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship him, don't let him deal with brothers. Give him guns, step back, watch him kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. I got love for my brothers, but we can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how it's supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me? I let it go back to when we played as kids, but then changed. That's the way it is. Let the Lord judge the criminals. If I die, I wonder if ever got a ghetto.